Grant, but that was hardly the first good game you've had. But to, you know, to do it in a win like that against that kind of team, you know, what kind of a boost is that for you personally?
It made me feel good, but honestly, right now I haven't really paid no mind to that game anymore because they're a great team, have a great coach, but we play a great team and a great coach on Saturday against Kansas State, and we're trying to get prepared for them.
You mentioned that. How much of a focus is it? Because you guys have had good games, you know, most recently at Vandy, and you know, just weren't able to necessarily build on it. What, you know, how much are you guys talking about? Let's not make this just a one game thing.
This is a test for us, whether or not we grow up, whether or not we show that it's not just a every now and again thing. Recently, or before, we had every time we played well, the next game I don't think we came out as strong or we just didn't play as hard. So it's really a huge test for us because it's a big game and they're a great team.
What do you think that is, that you didn't come out and play as hard or as strong the next game?
Honestly, I wouldn't be able to tell you because if I could, I don't think we would have done it. But the way that it was set up, we just weren't engaged mentally. I think it was, I'd credit it to a little bit of youth, but Hubs does a good job keeping us prepared, and he brings it every night, so we just have to follow his rule.
After a film session with Coach Barnes, is it kind of hard to tell whether you won or lost a game, like after Kentucky or Mississippi State?
Sometimes. Usually it's not that hard because on a loss, you watch a lot more film, you see what you do wrong, but Coach either way is on you either way. So he doesn't really try to get us too high after a win. He doesn't try to get us too down after a loss. So we just try to keep and maintain a certain level and come out every night and play.
What is it about Kansas State that sticks out what you've seen on film? What are your impressions?
They pass the ball efficiently, and they pass the ball with purpose. They don't just dribble the ball around. They don't take bad shots. They try and swing the ball, get everybody involved, and they can shoot 1-5 most of the time. They have a great worker in DJ Johnson and a great shooter in Dean Wade that our front court is going to have to handle, and then the guards are really good too, so we're prepared.
Grant, has it been tough this week to move past Kentucky? I'm sure as you walk around campus, people are saying good game and, you know, talking about it. Has it been tough at all this week to kind of put that behind you?
I wouldn't say so. People try and keep our minds on it because it's a big game. They say it's a great game in program history, but we try to keep the season going because our hopes is to make it to the tournament, and in order for us to do that, we have to keep winning, and we have to play hard every night rather than bring it one big game. We got to keep it every game, treat every game like a big game.
Did you go back and watch the highlights at all? I know you went back and watched film, but seeing highlights on social media or anything like that?
They popped up every now and again, whether I was watching SEC Network or one of those shows, because I'm not really a huge anime or cartoon guy, so I just stick to the sports channels. But I saw a few, but honestly, we're done with that by now because this practice is going to tell the tale of us because we need to be prepared for Saturday.
So I guess the rest of the team is cartoon guys? Is that what you're saying?
A couple of them, yes. I'd say so. A lot of the guys are goofy, so they enjoy those cartoons.
Grant, after y'all had so many, you know, chances to get one of those really good non-conference wins, I mean, obviously everyone gets fired up for SEC play, but is it nice to go get a chance to get another, to get a big non-conference win after a couple of those close losses?
It's nice. It felt good, and we're trying to feel good again because it's a huge game for RPI standpoint, and also just the Big 12 SEC Challenge we've watched since we were younger. All the freshmen talk about it. We enjoy playing it. We want to play in it, just like the ACC Challenge they have. It's just a huge game, so you don't usually get to play against guys like these. So just being able to play guys outside the conference during conference season is pretty cool, pretty sweet.
So you're going to be paying attention to what, I mean, obviously you're focusing on your game, but to see what the rest of the SEC does this weekend, because, you know, if the SEC is trying to get more teams into the big dance, I guess this is a big weekend to start doing some of that stuff.
I'd say so. Credit to those guys. Hope they do well, but represent the SEC, but I hope we got to get it done ourselves first.
Omar, you think you're rated passer when you had 6 assists today?
No, my passes vary sometimes. Sometimes it's good, sometimes it's bad. That's Coach Barnes. It was just a nice night, I'd say.
What about that behind the back one?
Never practiced it, but it worked.
what about the 2 touchdown passes to Bound and Pike?
That reminded me of just playing in high school when you used to just throw it out because guys would run. You don't have to worry about the rebound. Just once you have to steal or something like that, just throw it. Hopefully, they'll put it in the right spot and they'll get it.
Grant, are you surprising yourself at all, Nathan, that has happened so far? What were your expectations compared to where you are right now?
I have high expectations for myself, both on and off the court. So whether it would be a surprise, I wouldn't say that, but I feel like I have a long way to go. There's a lot more I can do. There's a lot more I can try and